guys, welcome back to another video. Today we got a new fish for the 30 gallon hexagon tank. If you guys remember, last week we actually got 4 albino Buenos Aires tetras, and they're doing great. And I don't know if you guys remember or not, it's been a long time since I've shown this fish, but if you guys remember my Le Lupe cichlid that I had, I actually had him in a 10 gallon in my room, and he was pretty much the only fish in there besides a little algae eater. And I went ahead and decided to move him out of that tank and out here in the hexagon tank. Didn't really know how well him and the Crevendus would get along, but so far they're getting along just fine. He's doing great in the tank, very active. He's been eating great, and he looks really, really good in the tank as well. So that's another new addition that I did in this tank off camera this week. But I got another really cool little fish today. He's fully grown, and this is a fish that I've been trying and really, really wanting to get for a long time now, and they're just kind of hard to come by, and they're just a really, really cool fish. And that fish is a dwarf pike cichlid. Now, if you guys remember, I actually used to have a black line pike, and he got fairly decent size and was very aggressive, but this guy's pretty well as big as he's gonna get, right around 3.5-4 inches, and really isn't all that aggressive, and it's just a really, really cool fish. Has a lot of personality, a lot of little cool features and designs and colors on him and all that. And he's called a green yellowtail dwarf pike cichlid, to be exact. There's a bunch of different kinds of pikes and dwarf pikes out there, but I figured this guy would be a great addition to the hexagon tank. So yeah, as I mentioned, the tank is looking really, really well. It just needs a little bit of water, just like all the tanks do, honestly. But I only add water to the tanks once a week, so during the week they get kind of low. But other than that, the tank is looking great. It is starting to get a little bit of some light shedding of algae back on the glass. But other than that, it's looking great. I also added some more jungle veil to the tank. If you guys remember when I first set it back up, I added some really, really short plants. But today I actually came across some pretty darn tall ones. So once these guys get going even more, it is going to look really, really nice. You can see some of the other ones right back there. And of course, the Anubias looks like it's starting to really establish itself onto the rocks. We have 4 of those in here. And that's pretty much it as far as plants. There's our tetras right up there, looking great. There's the Crevendus, and yeah, everybody in here is doing great. So now that we're adding this cichlid here, this pike cichlid, I think I may actually try to get one more Le Lupe and then a male Crevendus, and I think that might be it as far as fish. Now, if I don't get the Le Lupe, I think I might try to stick with getting the 2 Epistogramma, but if I can't come across those, which right now they're very, very hard to get, like nobody's got them, then I'll probably just stick with trying to get another Le Lupe, since the one that I put in here actually looks really, really good in here. So I don't know. I'll see whatever I do. Let me know what you guys think. If you think I should get another Le Lupe, or if you think I should try to get 2 Epistogramma. And over here in the inler tank, I'm thinking about moving this guy over there. This is my golden zebra loach. I got this guy about 6-7 months ago, and he was itty bitty when I first got him, and he's pretty well doubled in size now. And I feel pretty comfortable with moving him over there, and I think I might get 1 or 2 more of him if I actually do move him over there. But he's done great in this 10-gallon tank with all the guppies and the Cory cats. So I think I might just move that guy over there in the tank along with the other fish. And all these guys are doing great. There's our Japanese Larito guppies. And there's some of the, what are they called, tiger endlers in here. See if I can find some. There they are right there, the green-looking ones. And we really just have a mix of guppies and endlers. That's pretty much all this tank is. And then there's a one little sparkling grommy right there. And also the guppy grass, as you can tell. I know I showed you guys this tank last week, and as you can tell, it is starting to really make a comeback as well. So that'll look nice once this tank gets all filled back up with that again. But this guy was actually already acclimating a little while before I started filming, so he is plenty well acclimated and ready to go into the tank. All right, here we go in 3, 2, 1. There he goes. Gosh, this little guy's fast. There he is right there. Really light colored right now. Be really, really cool when he starts to color up in here. And he's going to look so good off the black gravel and the green plants. Check that guy out. Of course, the panda barb always got to be the one that tries to instigate stuff with the new fish. But yeah, just kind of, oh boy. There's the Le Lupe, checking him out. They actually are 2 completely different fish. I mean, they're both cichlids, but that's the only similarity. But they look very, very similar. Like, the body shape of the Le Lupe and the pike are very, very similar. That and the size of them. So there he is back there. And then the pike is right over there. See if I can get a better look at him. Oh, it's going back there now. Don't think I'll have any problems out of the crebenses. That's typically a pretty peaceful fish. But it'll be interesting to see. You know, and keep in mind the Lelupe's only been in this tank about 2 days, so that fish really hasn't established any kind of dominance in here either. So it is good that I'm adding this fish in here, being that the Lelupe has not been in here that long. But there he is right there. And like I said, this guy is not going to get very much bigger than this. This is a dwarf pike cichlid, and they don't really get no more bigger than probably 4, 4.5 inches or so. But yeah, that little guy's just kind of checking out the tank, checking out all the fish and all that. You know, I don't think he's going to bother anybody. And of course, it'll take him a couple days to really settle in and, you know, really start eating and all that. But yeah, I think this guy's going to be a great new addition to the tank. But yeah, pretty short video today. Hope you guys still did enjoy it though. And if you guys did, please be sure to give it a like down below. Also, let me know your guys' thoughts on the new dwarf pike cichlid, if you thought he was a good new add to the tank. And also, let me know what other kind of fish or dwarf cichlids you think I should add to the Hexagon tank as well. And I actually just rescaped one of my smaller 5.5 gallon tanks. So you guys will see that next weekend. And I've got some pretty cool ideas with that tank and also the tank that the Lelupe came out of as well. So be ready for that video. Like I said, drop a like on the video, hit that subscribe button if you guys are new to the channel. And with that being said, I will catch all of you guys in next Sunday's video. Peace.